quarter to go for season 1990, and to take up the call, Mark Aston once again.
13-9, 9-11. Here we go. What a wonderful way to finish over 110 years of history in South Australia. 87-65. Hines, the secondary knock. Seabone, Thompson. Hutton, over his head. Dean, read that beautifully. Needs support, gets it from Chigwidden. He'll have to be off. And is. Long kick, right half forward. Big pack and big mark. Murphy. Great start for his confidence in this last quarter. Long one, one out Fidge. As it turned out, three or four players came in. Liptak pulled off the ball. And away they go. This is Tregenza. Four, five bounces. Straight through the centre and straight down the middle to Smith. Seabone, Smith with him. Boas there as well. Desperation by Duthie. Jamieson. Now Duthie again. It's a high one. Hutton from behind. Dean in front. McDermott. And the skippers earn a free kick.
That's the way he plays. He's been a consistent player. Now off to Beau, with Jamieson seemingly across halfback.
Oh, he sets him up badly, but good enough to get it off to Hallahan. Defensive side of the centre circle. Here's Simons in space on the outer side centre wing. Touch of the fumbles for Tony Simons. Lost his footing. So everything went wrong for them then. It's not quite. Northeast versus Mansell. Simons up once again. Good persistence by Tony Simons, and he lays it off to Marshall, who is laid to the turf, and a 50-metre penalty.
Well, Paul Northeast is noted for this lack of discipline. He was late. Marshall turned his body. Now the best and most accurate kick on the field has a chance to put the Tigers closer.
Well, if you were a betting man, you'd have nearly the house on David Marshall.
First goal of the final term is a significant one. It gets the momentum moving.
15th kick for David Marshall. 10 metres out, directly in front, and he pops it through. His first goal, the margin back to 16 points. Can the Glenelg Tigers fight back? Only time will tell. We've played 2 minutes final term.
And they have relied upon their little men. Simons had real problems. Eventually protected well by Mansell, chipped for David Marshall, and Northeast late gave away the 50-metre penalty.
13-9 to 10-11, you can hardly hear yourself think. 50,000 screaming fans for either Port or Glenelg, the two best sides in the competition this year. McDermott goes down again. Hallahan to Jamieson, left footer. Mansell. Oh, Mansell was with Foster there, but Mackie didn't see that. And there'll be a ball up at left half forward.
Well, it's going to be the little things that count. Fitness will be critical in the final term. It's been a hard game.
13-9 to 10-11. The Magpies hold sway. Liptak's tackled in the centre. Murphy lays it off to Hallahan. He does the turn and kicks into half forward. Now numbers with Glenelg. Here's Bartlett. Duck the head, around the body, Liptak. He spilt the mark, but took a little bit of space. Oh, the hand pass straight to Rosonico was poor. And the Magpies will clear through Fiaci. Off the half-back line, a long one to the outer side centre wing. Christie up high. The run's provided by Thompson off the half-back line, a long one. Here's Liptak in the space. It's knocked to ground. Jennifer off to his vice-captain in Phillips. Inboard to Foster. Can he gather? No, he can't. Rosonico. Here's Ben Harris. He lumbers. Needs support. Gets it to the former Phillips. Slow motion here at Football Park. The pressure is immense. And Hutton gains possession. Centre wing, grandstand side. Sentry, who played a brilliant second term, a long one. Searching for Hodges. He's got the fly. Hodges! Can he break the record? He's 40 metres out. And he's taken his seventh mark.
Now he's kicking with the breeze. No impression of injury. High. Dropping back was Gibbs. Little Duthie could do. With the breeze at his back, it won't put pressure on the left leg.
So his 11th kick coming up, Scott Hodges. From 40, he lays back and he puts it through. That is the record. A great performance by Scott Hodges. The McGeary and Ken Farmer medalist breaks the goal kicking record here in South Australia. 152 goals, and the Magpies surge further ahead.
A standing ovation. 50,000 people at Football Park salute the champion. The record is Scott Hodges, the boy from Salisbury West, a junior champion fighting for the McGarry Medal, the Ken Farmer Award, and now the record for the most goals in a season.
A very emotional time. 14-9 to 10-11. This game still has to be won, though. Simons, Thompson, away from defence, over the head of Northeast. Mansell, intelligent. That's Tregenza. Dean's got him. Tregenza got away with it, though. Hutton runs onto it, can't gather. Hand pass was a little loose. Setri. Still with Setri, and that is desperation personified as Dean is there as well. And there'll be a ball up 55 metres from the Port goal. We've played almost 6 minutes of the last turn. You're watching this on ABC television. 14-9 to 10 goals, 11. Williams out of the congestion. Hodges, yes!
Well, he read it quickest. Mark Williams snapped it on the boot. Doothy was committed to the lead in front. And Scott Hodges, dropping back, took a simple mark.
This is the real Scott Hodges. Knee injury or not, he's broken the record. He wants a premiership. 15 metres out. But he's missed. Shave the post. 14-10 to 10-11.
And the little thing's going with Port Adelaide. Setri, a brilliant player, earned his chance when David Brown couldn't play. Those three kick goals and a really determined Rovers game.
The Magpies by 23 points. Here's Dean in defence for Glenelg. The tumble punt kick to centre wing on the outer side. Foster gathers now the second attempt to Northeast. A hurried kick to centre half forward. Great courage shown by Thompson. Now the run's provided by Bowe. Can Glenelg mount a comeback? Bowe up towards half forward. Fidge. The numbers were the Tigers, but good work by Rosonico to Phillips. Out wide to Abernathy. Off the half-back line, the chip pass is good. He's got two players to choose from. One is Hutton. Lays it off to Williams, a long one. Hodges on the long lead. Oh, that is brilliantly done. He saw the lead of the fourth forward, and he put it perfectly.
Well, he knows he can make this distance. Dropping back with Sebo, couldn't lay a hand on the ball. And again, the wind at Hodges' back.
His 13th kick coming up, Scott Hodges. He'll shoot from 45, favours the right-hand post. Good-looking kick. His sixth goal, Scott Hodges. And the Magpies open up a 29-point lead.
Well, at Cecilia, it's going to be very difficult for the Tigers to come back. Chipping short. Jennifer supporting Hutton. Stephen Williams in the space. The kick in front, and Hodges suddenly looking at the ball only and forgetting about Lim.
Long kick by Hodges, and we've seen him do that so many times this year. He really is a superb player. Tregenza, who's had a lot of touches, to centre-half forward. Sebo, Marnie, now Gibbs. Inside the defensive 50, out to the wing. Christie. Port Adelaide there in numbers. Northeast. Up to right half forward. Thompson and Setri. Now Tregenza. This brilliant youngster. It's a high one. Hodges again. This time it's two against one. And Smith goals! Two against one the other way. And Smith is elated. So is Hodges. 35 points the margin. That was Smith's second.
3-1. In the final term, Tregenza on top now at centre wing. Put it in. Doothy outnumbered. Hodges tapping over the top will give him the benefit of the doubt. And Darren Smith, who has been a quiet player, kicks his second. Just inside. And his eighth kick.
So the Magpies playing inspired football, lead by 35 points. They go ahead once again through Mark Williams. A spiral punt kick to Hodges. It's knocked to ground. Bowe onto Seabome, a sweeping hand pass. Now it doesn't sit for Jamieson, he gathers on the second attempt. Chips in short, too much carry for Simons on the outer side, half-back flank. And it's forced out of play.
Well, the Magpies have been at their best since half-time. They really have applied the pressure. They've kept the key forwards for Glenelg under control.
Here's Liptak in defence for the Tigers. Forced onto the left side. A long one, Chigwidden underneath the ball. Force wide, northeast onto Rizonico, who chips in looking for Ginever. He went to play on, but to be called back on his mark. I think just the momentum carried him past John Seabone on that occasion.
And the run, dropping back, plenty of time, looking to see what the options were. Rizonico's down, the short pass to Hutton.
Came unstuck though, coming through is Ginever. Knocks it out wide to Setri. It's a bright half forward for the Magpies, and a bounce will occur. Umpires Mackey and Argent, with umpire Kinnear off the ground with a leg injury, so Laurie Argent off the interchange bench.
That right calf muscle of Rick Kinnear unable to handle the pressure of the big one.
Smith, quick kick. Gibbs. Hutton runs onto it. He's 4 or 5 metres in front of Bowe. Not for long, though. Round the corner, Williams had three, grabs at it and has taken it. He's always a good kick. It's a high one. Hodges storms out. So too Smith. They'll need to talk here. Seabome, Thompson. Back it goes to Gibbs. In front of the defensive goal. Now Liptak. Out wide to Jamieson. They need desperately to get a couple of quick goals, Glenelg. Simons, who knows all about grand finals. Long drop punt to left half forward, and George Fiarchi just stood there like a man and took it easily in front of his hands. That was his 15th mark.
He's been a pillar of strength and defence for the Magpies, northeast. A hurried one. Now Marnie has to fly against two. Glenelg with the numbers. Thompson hands it off to Duthie. A short passes on, and it finds Simons on the outer side half-back flank. Run provided by Duthie. Here's Liptak, but a mistake of the hands as Setri was bearing down, but a long kick by Matthew Liptak. Oh, great mark by Hines. He flew from the side, and he took it on the chest. Concedes ground back to Phillips. The big fella's on his hands and knees at centre-half forward. Umpire Argent calls play on as the snapshot from Bartlett to the vacant goal square. Which way will it bounce? Here's Mansell. He needs a bit of luck. Ben Harris has the ball, but it's jarred wide, and Hines clears. He chips it short. Here's Foster in defence. A bit of space, a long one to the outer side centre wing. Coming in, though, is Gary Christie, and he takes a good mark.
So Christie, oh, he's lost it. Tregenza, like a magician. Northeast, awkward kicking style, straight to Gibbs, though. And Gibbs will mop up. He goes very wide. Put Thompson under a bit of pressure. Sentry's bearing down on him. He forces the error. Well done by Setri.
Horns to bring on Melican. Mansell to have a spell. He needs something up forward to take a mark or to get some movement.
13 and a half minutes. 16, 10 to 10, 11. 50,589 fans witnessing this excellent game of football, and Port Adelaide turning it on in the second half. Phillips push out, though. Fiarchi went up as well. Now, this is Murphy. Chips to space. Melican, who's just come on, lumbers after it. He goes in short to Fidge, and he's found the full forward. Some suggesting that wasn't a mark, but he's got it. He's kicked four.
He's been a good player up front. Harris has done well. Melican coming off the interchange, just chipping with the right leg. So the Magpies controlling the game, but the Tigers still a chance.
Ninth kick coming up for Fidge. And if ever he needs to get one, this is it. 16-10 to 10-11. 35 metres out. And he's got it. So the margin is not quite as much as it was. 6 points they retrieve it. 16-10 to 11-11.
Murphy directing the ball across the ground. Melican needed the bounce. Wanted to turn back, chip with the right foot, and Harris just a little slow. So can the Bays come back? They trail, and seconds are ticking by. Probably about 12 minutes of play yet left.
So the Magpies hold sway by 29 points back in the centre. Melican won it down. Here's Simons. A hurried kick to left half forward. Now the bounce will favour Phillips. No, it doesn't in the end. Chick-Whitten steals it. Inside 50. Long kick by Nicholas Chick-Whitten. Just offline. But a good attempt by the Rover. And Glenelg 11-12-78. They trail Port Adelaide 16-10-106.
And it did show that the breeze is not that strong. He kicked the ball a long way. Perhaps would have been better to try and pass off and find a teammate in a better position.
There's still time. 28 points. Rozonico falls over after getting rid of that kick. It was a long one too. Simons appeared to get one high and did. So he'll boot this back into attack. Now he squares it. Gibbs. Well done by Williams. Now Jamieson round the corner. And the defence working overtime in this last 2 or 3 minutes of Port Adelaide. Gibbs back in defence again. So time ticking away. This is Thompson. Right footer, right half forward. Murphy, two to beat, and did it okay. A kick and a bit out. Goes in short to young Liptak. Hines comes at him, but Liptak's got it.
A good game from Liptak. Gained a lot of valuable experience.
Liptak goes short. Into a pack of players. One of them was Rozonico. Not able to take the mark. Fitch round the corner, and it's wide. That must have been touched off the boot.
Well, I think he was called to play on. And Rozonico gesturing to the umpire. Fidge has two particular goals that he has missed today that we would have expected him to get. That was one of them, and they're both significant.
Nearly 17 minutes of play gone in the final term. Port Adelaide 16-10 to Glenelg 11-13. A big kick in. It's past the centre for the Magpies. Setri over the ball. Nice knock on by Wanganeen. Well, coming through like a steam train with Seabone. A long one to centre-half forward. Phillips down towards Hines. Run out wide provided by Hutton. So the Magpies building. A poor hand pass sets up Mark Williams. He needs a bit of luck and support. Bearing down with Simons for pace advantage. As Mark Williams goes in very hard. Now there's a lot of committed players out there. Both Simons and Williams have played fine games for their respective clubs.
Well, Mark Williams decided that that ball was going out of bounds.
79 playing 106, Port lead. Here's Jennifer. Russell Evert type hand pass. And it's out of play once again.
Well, Port will be happy to see the seconds tick away. Glenelg need to open up the forward line. They need a match-winning half-forward.
17, almost 18 minutes gone. This is the dangerous Hutton. Short pass to Hodges. Excellent. Juggles it and takes it.
Well, he's not at his best, obviously. The concentration is down a little bit. But overcoming the knee injury, having kicked the record, and now quite calm.
He'll kick from about 40 metres out. Scott Hodges, 10 marks. This is his 14th kick. It's a pressure kick. 18 and a half minutes he's missed. So, Darrell, that knee obviously a problem, but he's still done a marvellous job.
Yes, I'll bet at half-time the doctor and the physio had a big decision to make with Scott Hodges. It paid off. He's come back. He's now kicked five, kicked six in a, we'll almost call it a match-winning performance.
Gibbs runs inside his defensive 50, a long one to the outer side centre wing. Here's Foster, who's been a rebounding defender for the Magpies. Stephen Williams spilt a market centre half forward. Simons dispossessed. Wanganeen doing some heavy work. A lot of players at centre-half forward for the Magpies. And the bounce will occur. Umpire Laurie Argent in now.
Desperation stuff. Ross Gibbs, in that recent incident, Phelps behind the play went down when shepherded, and Gibbs cleared.
The bounce at right-half forward for Port. Hallahan back to Gibbs. He's been a good player for the Tigers, a long one. Now it's Dean versus Hutton. Dean the spoil from behind, but good persistence by David Hutton. And it's out of play in between half-forward and the left full forward pocket.
And Glenelg started on top across the centre, but since half-time or maps quarter-time, Port have lifted.
28 points in it, Port lead. They're into attack once again. Lumbering out is Harris. Oh, he ducked ahead but got off the set treat. Now there's a decision holding the ball. So the free kick in defence to Jamieson. The player was Phelps, in fact.
Just not the agility to be able to evade.
Seabohm off half-back. A poor kick falls in the arms of Simons through centre. A good foot pass finds Chigwidden. He's well outside 50, but Fidge on the lead. Well put. Fine ball from Harris. It's knocked to ground, but Glenelg have the numbers. Here's Hallahan, claimed beautifully by Ginnivan. And it's bottled up well in defence. So a bounce will occur 45 metres out from the Tigers' goal.
Hallahan not the vision to see Ginnivan coming down from behind. Fidge was on the movement.
28 points, Port Adelaide lead, 20 and a half minutes. This is it, the grand final of 1990. And it won't be the same next year with a South Australian team in the national competition. 16-11 to 11-13. Inside the attacking 50 for Glenelg. Foster, Brazonico it was, holding the ball. Chigwidden, a big chance, Darrell.
Aggressive. Kicked a long shot recently. His full face of wind, though.
We'll put this in long. Drop punt. It is long. Just touched, and it's still in play now, out of bounds, right forward pocket. So 16-11 to 11-13, and perhaps another 8 minutes of the 1990 grand final.
And the Magpie defence makes it very hard.
In attack for the Tigers, they trail by 28. Here's McDermott. Bearing down was Mark Williams, though. Gets it back. A hurry kick out of defence. Abernathy did beautifully. Look at the vision for northeast. Inside his defensive 50. Two bounces. Bartlett runs at him, but he chips it in towards Phelps. Support back from northeast, who tries the soccer off the ground. That was ambitious. Setry goes in hard. Northeast gets it back. A long one, a spiral putt kick to centre half forward. But Seabohm in the way. He hands it off to Doofy, who provides good rebound. Ugh. Gets around Wanganeen. Was that intentional? We may never know. A long one. The centre half forward, Christie in the way, and he'll get the free kick.
Got to get on with it.
Well, he took an excellent mark early in the game. And that mark, he stood his ground. Williams was late. So he is an accurate kick. And about 35 metres out.
His fourth kick coming up, Gary Christie. 40 metres out, time running out for the Bays. He pops it up, good-looking kick, comes back, and he's put it through. His first goal, and the Tigers edge back. They boot their 12th. 23 minutes gone in the final term. Glenelg 12-13 to Port Adelaide 16-11.
Well, Doothy did brilliantly. He evaded, turned inside. The height of Christie. Williams a little late, the ball held, holding up in the breeze, and a precise kick which just made the distance.
So can Glenelg pull off a miracle win in this, the 1990 grand final? 22 points in it, 16-11 to 12 goals, 13. Sentry, an important kick out of the centre in the context of this game. Centre half forward for Port Adelaide, and they keep it in the area. Williams gets up.
Going to need a lot of run from the little men of Glenelg. Simons has played well this quarter. Marshall has been hurled by a very defensive Abernathy.
1.5 minutes to go before we reach time on. Liptak somehow got the kick away into the centre. Chigwidden, a mistake with the hands. It bounced off his chest. And they had a chance then to work that ball forward. Jack Kyle Darrell, what would he be thinking?
Well, he'd be trying to solve all the little things. He wants the body to be covered. He's keeping on looking at defensive action. He wants plenty of black and white Guernseys across half-back and full-back.
I think we caught just the latter part of that message. Very intense by John Cale. Here's Liptak on the outer side centre wing. Knocks it back. McDermott, a good knock-on in the path of Jamieson. A sweeping left-foot pass. Here's Fidge opposed to Harris. Fidge did beautifully with the body. He straightens around the body. Good-looking shot by Fidge. And the mark on the goal face to Michael Murphy.
Will be paid. Goal umpire perfectly placed. Fidge, no doubt, shooting for goals. Well, they're online. It's going to take him right around, which is accurate. There must be a line between the mark and the centre of the goal square.
His seventh kick coming up, Murphy. 5 metres out, he puts it through. So the margin edged back to 16 points. Still time left for the Bays. 25 minutes gone in the final term of the 1990 Grand Final.
Fidge wheeling, spearing the kick to the square. Murphy took cleanly. The goal, his third. It's a beautiful kick from that angle. The Godalming supporters lift. Murphy knows there's a chance. The Tigers, can they come home?
7 goals kicked in this, the last quarter, so perhaps another 5 minutes of football. 16-11 to 13-13. It'll be important from this point. Phillips. Bartlett's with him. Abernathy. Williams. And Liptak. And there's a Tiger supporter. I don't think there's any questioning that. Unless he's an impersonator. 16-11 to 13-13. Almost 26 minutes gone. Another goal by Glenelg would make this very interesting. Marshall intelligently. Callaghan, a sweeper. Now Simons. You've got to kick it or hand pass, and he does the latter. Round the corner goes Marshall. Over the top, Murphy. A chance, no. It bounces through for a behind to the right-hand side. David.
Looking dangerous. Glenelg, no, they've got a chance. You watch the Magpies' experienced players now really work hard to slow the game down.
So 15 points in at Port, still lead. Foster to the grandstand side. Harris up high. Out wide to the run of Hutton. But he's happy to see it over the boundary.
Well, Greg Phillips was the player who enabled Harris to make that mark unattended.
So we're approaching the 27-minute mark of the final term. Through comes Liptak, but there was no passage through that pack for Matthew Liptak, who's had a pretty good game. The youngster, plagued by injury this season.
No lack of courage.
Umpire Mackey in his first grand final. He's done a good job too. The bounce at right half forward for the Tigers. Here's Chig Whitten. Numbers with the Magpies. Wanganeen. High tackle. And what he does get in attention, he certainly lets the umpire know, and I suppose in a way that's a skill on its own.
Yeah, certainly a light player. Chick Whitten was a little bit undisciplined. And a light frame player can simply win the free, but it was legitimate. Now, Mark Williams tells the junior to take his time. They'll play to the line and play for time.
11th kick for Wanganeen. Port lead by 15 points. Good knock on by Darren Smith in the path of Stephen Williams. He's got support in Tregenza, but he's used to kicking these, Stephen Williams, but on that occasion just hooked it offline, had the breeze at his back, so the margin back to 16.
Still 3 straight kicks in it, still possible, but Port Adelaide very defensive.
Gibbs puts everything into that kick. Duthie, Tregenza, high kick, setting up his forward. Hodges, Phelps was there as well. Gibbs, Thompson. Williams runs after him and drags him down. Great tackle. Wonderful desperation by Williams.
Well, just imagine how tired the players are. They've given it their all, so the skill factor should be down.
16 points, Port Adelaide lead. Very close to their third premiership in a row. High kick by Bowe. In front of the members. Good strong mark there taken by Murphy.
Chance for Glenelg to get inside half forward. Murphy has certainly lifted since half time.
Half back, Jamieson. And the crowd is going wild. They can sense this premiership as Port Adelaide's. Phillips in the van. Bartlett, Liptak runs onto it. Sweeper, Chig Whitten. Over it goes to Christie, runs into the open goal and has missed. And the crowd, the Glenelg supporters go, oh.
Absolutely critical, that shot. The dive of Rosonico. That's an expression of how dedicated the black and white Guernsey is.
So time running out for the Magpies. In fact, for the Tigers, they lead by 15 points, Port Adelaide. Hutton's 15th kick off the half-back line. Looking for Hodges, who's well down from his full forward position. And he gets the applause from the Magpie supporters. Scott Hodges. Approaching the 30-minute mark of the final term. So perhaps, no, I was going to say a minute away, but the 1990 Premiership to Port Adelaide. Winners by 15 points. Scott Hodges and Tim Ginnivan fall to the ground. A third consecutive grand final for Port Adelaide and also coach John Cale. The final score, Port Adelaide 16-12-108, Glenelg 13-15-93. So a clean sweep to the Magpies in Perth, South Australia and Victoria.
Well, they deserve to win this premiership. Three in a row now. We've seen Mark Williams home from the Brisbane Bears mid-season. Timmy Ginnivan. There's coach John Cale. As fit as they come. And Port Adelaide proving that they had what it took to make it three in a row.